Hi everyone, it's Mari. So today I'm going to show you a little bit of how I organize my fountain pen things. So if this is something that you're interested in, just keep on watching. Okay, so I have a very small fountain pen collection. As you can see, I only have five, and I only have, I think, five inks as well. But I'm starting to organize myself because I plan on getting a few more inks and perhaps a couple more pens as well. But I would just like to start by showing this box. So this is a box that I got in the university used store, and this is a wooden box that it's I think it was originally made to store some sort of instrument, measuring instrument. I don't really know what was the instrument that was inside this, but it was just like an empty wooden box. As you can see, it's a little bit taller. And then what I did is I just removed all of the foam that it had inside, that used to hold the instrument, and I basically just sand it all down, and it's ready to be used. So yeah, so if we open up here, we can see that I only have a few things, and I will probably have to adapt this later if I want to increase my collection. But basically, I just have a few pipettes here. These are just plastic pipettes, and I bought a whole bunch of them. I actually bought this on Amazon before I knew about the university used materials, because they sell leftover pipettes as well. But yeah, I use these ones just if I need to swatch some ink, or if I need to refill cartridges. I tend to use this type of pipettes, and as you can see, I have a whole bunch of them, but I actually name the pipettes, one for each ink that I have, just so if in the case that there is any residual ink here, I won't contaminate with a different ink. So I just put like a name for each of the inks that I currently have, and then if I need to, I can grab the specific pipette for that ink. This is definitely not necessary, but it made my life a little bit easier. The next thing I have here are just a couple of dip pen holders. So this is the oblique, and this is just a regular dip pen holder. I haven't used this one as much, and I just recently bought the oblique one, and I've been really enjoying using this one. So basically, you just insert the nib here, and then you dip the nib on the ink, and then you just write with it. So yeah, I've been really enjoying writing with the oblique one. And then I have one flat brush, and I use this one whenever I want to swatch an ink. And I'm gonna show my swatch booklet here in a moment, and how I organize my ink swatches as well. But I like to use my brush to do that, just because I can actually spread the ink a little bit easier than with a cotton tip. So yeah, I've been using this brush here to do some ink swatches. And then for inks, I also hold a few inks here, just because I have bottled inks and I don't really have a good place to store them right now, and I have a cat that goes everywhere, so I just wanted it to be a little bit more secure. So I actually have this Ecoline watercolor ink here, and I use this mostly with the with my oblique dip pen, just because it's easier, and I like these colors as well. They have a bunch of colors, and they are not expensive, so I like using this watercolor ink for that. The next ink I have is this Rhorer and Klingner. This is a sketch ink in the shade T. I like this a lot. This is a waterproof ink, and my initial idea was to use this one with my Hobonichi, and basically because I wanted to have the option to watercolor on my Hobonichi if I wanted to. Long story short, I haven't been watercoloring in my Hobonichi, and the issue with these waterproof inks is that they are much harder to clean from your fountain pen if you don't clean it as often. So I was cleaning my fountain pens every 1 or 2 months, and this ink tends to dry a little bit, and then it becomes a little bit harder to clean. So I've been avoiding using this ink in anything other than watercolor. So yeah, I still use it, but I don't use it as much, and it's kind of like a brownish gray ink, I would say. Sort of like this color here. But yeah, this is my second ink, and then the next one I have is this one, and I just put a washi tape here to try to keep it shut because it doesn't have any mechanism to keep this box shut. But this is the Pilot Iroshizuku, and I have the tsuki-yo, kon-peki, and take-sumi inks. These are great inks. I really like those. I've been using a lot of the take-sumi one for this month's journaling, but I think next month I'm gonna use the tsuki-yo. Yeah, so then I have these three ink bottles here, and that's pretty much it. So that's all of the inks that I keep here. And then I have some things. Oh, yeah, I also have this thing here, just black ink that came with this dip pen kit. And I really haven't used this, but I just keep it here just in case I decide to use it. And then for cleaning, I just have, other than my plastic pipette tips here, I have my, I don't know how this is called, like a syringe. And again, I bought this from the university used store. And so the thing with this one is this is a little bit smaller than what you would buy in a fountain pen shop, for example. But you basically just fill this with water, and then you can grab your fountain pen and just press the water down through the feed, right? So it will clean. It will give a little bit of pressure to help you clean the nibs and the feed. So I have this one. I haven't used it yet, but I'm assuming it's gonna be okay. So it's just to give it like an additional pressure for the water to go through the pen. And then I also have this. This is actually a pipette syringe that I also got at the university used store. They sell a lot of used lab things. So basically, this in a lab setting, you would have your pipette plugged in here, and then you can just fill this with whatever solution you're using, and then you usually can calibrate how much you want to dispense or dispose in one press, right? So you can say that you want, for example, 0.2 milliliters of solution, and then you can just press, and it will always dispense only 0.2 milliliters. So this is very useful in a lab setting, but for cleaning my fountain pens, what I thought is, again, this would help me just give that a little bit extra pressure whenever I'm cleaning something a little bit more, a little bit smaller. So for example, if I want to clean an empty cartridge, I could use this to help me have that additional pressure, water pressure, to clean and empty my cartridge. So that's what I was thinking about using this one for. And then I have a few glass bottles here, and then I just keep one with clean water and one with dirty water. And this is just because if I'm using my glass dip pan for doing some swatches, I can just quickly clean my pan here. So what I would do is if I dip my pen in ink to write down, and then if I want to clean them, if I want to clean my pen before switching inks, I would just put it in the dirty water until most of the ink is out of my pen, and then I would just clean it a little bit on the clean water one more time, just to make sure that I don't have any residual ink on my glass dip pen. So that's pretty much why I keep these two bottles for. And then my third glass bottle, I just keep my nibs. So we can open here, maybe. Yeah, we can open here. And these are all of the nibs for my dip pen holders. So my oblique nibs and everything else, I just keep them here, just so they are all secure. And then I have some additional cartridges. I have this Coeco cartridge. I actually don't have a Coeco pen, but I bought this thinking it would work, and it does work with one of my fountain pens, because this is a universal cartridge, international universal cartridge. I have a few Pilot cartridges. I haven't been using them, but I might try using them again. And then I have this manuscript cartridges, that these are just colorful universal cartridges as well, and I used a few of them. I still have to use the rest of them, and that's pretty much it for this box here that I have that holds all of my fountain pen things. So I'm just gonna put all of these away in sort of the order that I had it before, just so I don't, just so it's easier for me later. I can just sort of make it fit here. And then these ones, I just kind of have them around here, and this one here. So that's it for my wooden box here. And then for keeping my fountain pens, I have my glass dip pen just in a regular pen holder here. This is kind of dangerous because I could kind of drop this, but it's very secure here in a corner in which my cat won't really get into it. And I have some things here that would prevent me from knocking this over. So I keep my glass dip pen there, and then my other pens, I just keep them in this leather pen holder that I made myself with my husband, with my husband's help. And I just have my Kakuno, Pilot Kakuno pen here with an extra fine nib. And then I also have this Noodler's Ahab with a flex nib. And I keep those two together because these are the two that I'm currently using for my journaling. And those are inked. And these three here are not inked, but I have a Lamy Safari in a fine nib. I have a Pilot Metropolitan in a fine nib, I guess. It's been a while since I used it. Yeah, in a fine nib. And then I also have this Crown fountain pen, which I don't know the exact model of this pen, but it's a very old one that my dad actually gave me. So I have this one, and this is sort of like a broad nib. It doesn't even say the size, but I think it's either a medium or a broad nib. So these are all the pens I have currently. And then for swatches, I have this Col-o-ring testing book. So I have this Col-o-ring testing book, and it has a specific Col-o-ring paper. So this paper, this is a white paper. It's a kind of like a heavy cardstock. I'm not really sure, you know, the material. It's a specific paper of this particular swatch book. So I'm using this mostly to get an idea of the color or the shade of the ink. So I'm just writing the name on the brand and the ink name, and then I do like a round swatch. And I for this particular paper, I just include a little bit of water as well, just so I can see a little bit of the variation there. And then I just do some extra doodling, just to, again, just as an example of how the ink would look if I were drawing using it with my glass dip pen. So I have my Pilot iroshizuku inks here, and then I have my Rhorer and Klingner ink and my watercolor ink. So then, other than this coloring swatch book, I also made a similar swatch book with Fabriano paper, which is something that's really accessible for me here, and it's sort of fountain pen friendly. So I just made a few swatches in the Fabriano paper as well. So again, the same five inks, just in a different paper. And what I want with this is not only to see how the color would look like in this paper, but I also want to know if I'm going to have a lot of bleed through or ghosting using these inks. So I have the Fabriano paper here, and then I also have a smaller paper here, and I had to cut this short just because I was using a Hobonichi booklet, which is a little bit shorter. So I also did the same thing. I just cut some pages out of my Hobonichi booklet, just to Weeks booklet, just to make a swatch. And this is just because, again, it's a different paper, but also the Hobonichi Weeks, which is the one that I use the most for journaling, it's kind of a cream color, so the colors will look different. So I wanted to have a sample here as well. And again, I also want to see the shading and bleed through. So if you see, I didn't have any bleed through on these, but for the watercolor ink, I kind of started having some bleed through here, but a lot of ghosting. So just to keep that in mind, because I do use my Hobonichi Weeks a lot. And then lastly, I put some papers here as well with the Midori MD notebook as well, because this is also fountain pen friendly, and it's a little bit cream color as well. So I just wanted to see if there were any differences in the coloring, but also regarding ghosting and bleed through. So that's pretty much what I've been doing in terms of swatches. And then lastly, I also am keeping this page here in my Filofax Malden pocket size, and I use this as my wallet. I carry my passport with me here, so I have just one page here with catalog bottle ink, and then I just use my paintbrush here that I have it on my wooden box here. I just use it to do just a little bit of a swatch, just very small, and then I include the name of the ink here and the date that I bought it, just so I have an idea of how old my ink bottles are, and I might want to prioritize using one over the other just because it's getting older. So that's pretty much it. I also write down anything that I might want to know about. So I have this here that says this is a watercolor ink, and I also have this to symbolize that this is a waterproof ink. So the idea with this is that I want to avoid trying to order too many inks in a similar shade, but I also want to have this easily available for me, and since this is my wallet, I carried this with me all the time, so I have this easily available. So I can see that I have two blue inks, and I have one black and one gray. So next time I might want to avoid the blues and the grays and blacks, just so I can have a wider range of colors to work with. And then I just prepared here another page here for ink samples, and I ordered a few ink samples, and the idea is that I'm going to swatch them here as well, just to avoid ordering multiple samples or ordering a sample that I already got in the past. And then for the samples, I actually am not planning to swatch them in all of the papers that I have here, so I'm just planning on swatching them on the coloring test book, just so I can have a better idea of the color of the ink color. I might use this on the Hobonichi paper as well. Maybe, I'm still thinking about it. Because that also gives me an idea of the Tomoe River paper, which is what I'm using for my journaling as well. So that's pretty much it. That's pretty much how I organize my fountain pen things. Yeah, and that's it. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you have any tips for me, let me know. I'm mostly just starting with fountain pens. I don't have much on my collection. But yeah, I'm trying to be really mindful of the things that I buy. So I have a few fine and extra fine nibs. So I want my next fountain pen to be something like in a medium or broad, or maybe a stub, just so I can try different things and see how I like those. And I've been using those a lot for journaling, and I've been enjoying them a lot. So that's it. If you have any tips or any comments, feel free to let me know. But other than that, if you enjoyed it, feel free to hit the like button as well. It will let me know that you want to see more of this type of content. So yeah, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.